All right, guys, I'm here with Alysha Newman. This is Doug with Valter Magazine at the Valter Magazine Training Facility. Alysha is the Commonwealth Games champion, yes. Canadian record holder, Diamond League win with a PR of 15 feet 10 inches. We are very blessed to have Alysha here at our facility to come out here and train with us and take a look around. I have a few questions I want to ask her. First and foremost, what she's looking at and what you're feeling coming into the Olympic year. I mean, what are we, 80 days?
Yeah, a little bit less.
Are you counting the days down on how many days?
I think it's like 76, yeah. To be exact.
So 76 days before you go, and you guys are leaving on Monday.
I'm leaving Monday to go back to Toronto, getting on full approach, and then getting ready for a couple Diamond Leagues. I got about 4 Diamond Leagues before I head out and go to Tokyo, so I'm super stoked. I'm super excited. It's been a long year and a half of training, so I think a lot of us athletes are just ready to get out on the track and compete and show everybody what we've been working on.
And I think that was one of the questions I asked you a little bit ago was, you know, how do you get yourself back fired up again after you've been training for so long to get ready for these Olympics? Mm-hmm. And the pandemic hits, of course, that's all old news. And it's going on.
Yeah.
But as you try to get yourself in the right mindset and frame of mind heading to Olympics, what's your plan? What are you thinking of? I know you're going to go home, be around family and friends, Diamond League meets, but you know, we're really rooting for you. We're going to get you back up to that 15 to 10 and 16 feet and all that kind of fun stuff. So what's your plan?
Yeah, I think for us, it was, our plan was to get back into what my goals were after 2019. You know, when 2020 hit and our whole season got put on pause, we revamped all our goals. So this year, you know, you go back and what motivates me is my goals that I need to accomplish by the end of 2021. And that is bring home a medal for my country, and that is to jump 16 feet. It's always been, every year I've gotten better, at least we say 5 to 10 centimeters, I've been getting better every year, and that's what we want to keep doing. I'd much rather continue that upward scale than to plateau. And that's just something that, you know, you see it in the training, you see it in the Diamond League meets, but to actually clear those heights, you want those to be consistent, because if you're going out and jumping those 80s, 480s, 490s every time, you're going to be in the top 1, 2, or 3.
Yeah, right now for 2021, you're number 3 in the world, correct?
I know.
Yeah, how's crazy. That sound? That sounds great, doesn't it?
It's always nice to see that, but I love to like always do one better, you know, after 2020. I was still 3rd, so it's like now I got to be 2nd or 1st, you know?
Yeah.
So.
Well, that's amazing. I mean, look at the company you're with at that top of that list. I mean, that's cranking, you know?
Well, it's funny because my whole career, you know, I'm really considered the underdog. You know, you hear it on the Diamond League, they say, you know, Alysha doesn't win much, but she's always right there. And it's nice to have that because there's not as much pressure on me. But I'm kind of like over that. You know, I want to be one of the best pole vaulters to ever walk. And I know I'm definitely one of the best technicians. So now it's all just, it all coming together on the perfect day, and that'd be the Olympic Games.
Well, at 15:10, you know what I mean? You can't deny the fact that at 477, right? Or is it?
482. Yeah.
So my right up here. Nope, 482 right there.
Yeah.
But at 482, how can you deny the fact that you're not a top notch Olympic athlete heading into the 2021 Olympics? And that's just...
That's hard, right? It's hard to answer it because it's
like,
that's
it kind of gives you the
really
chills
high.
A little bit. Deep breath, you know? I mean, it's out here at 80 degrees, but it kind of makes you think like, man, you know, we're 70, 80 days away from the big show, you know? Yeah. And you're sitting at number 3, and we just got to make sure you time it up correctly to where you're peaking at the right time and getting on the right poles and getting everything running together. Tell me about when you went over to France and hung out with Renaud Lavallenie and his coach, Philippe.
Yeah,
and all those guys. They're just a classic group of dudes. I sat with Philippe and Renaud at the Olympic Training Center and did an interview just like
this. Oh, amazing.
And it was right after, it was 30 days after he did his world record jump and he had burst his heel. And I'll tell you, he jumped for 2.5 hours, took his shoe off, and all the way around his heel in a half moon with stitches and scar. And it had only been 30 days. And I'm like, look at this guy back out there killing it. So anyways, a bunch of crazy dudes from France. Mm-hmm. Tell us about that experience and what you gained out of it.
I think for me, it was to go down to be with coaches that are kind of like my style of coaching or my jumping. You know, I look at Americans and I think they're incredible, but a lot of it is grip high, run fast, and I'm a very more attentive, I'd much rather know what's going on the whole time, and very technical base on the pole. And so I always saw Renaud, you know, he always broke that data. He broke, you know, shorter, but gripping these high poles and bringing in energy that people really don't understand how that was working. So for me to go down and see their mentality on the way they look at pole vault was just mine, but almost like 10 times more level up. You know, it's like riding a bike for them. You know, they just don't even think about it. The best drill that I saw them do when I was down there, they threw the shoe on the runway And all eight guys grabbed a pole and they said, we got to all start from this mark. Let's see how many people can clear. And just they adjusted their step up there. And that is what is incredible to me. You know, we plan and we get mid marks and we get steps, but they made it work. Every single guy went from the same shoe mark. And it was just incredible to see, incredible to watch. Their mental toughness on the runway is nothing like I've ever seen before. They put themselves in positions not to just compete together, but to be at the elite level. You have to have almost this swag and this honor of jumping 580 plus to be around those guys. So it's pretty cool to like be in that environment and surround yourselves with people that are better than you, because if you're around people that, you know, are not as good or just your level, how are they gonna push you, right? And,
sure.
And that's what was the mentality, to go down and really learn what, open my mind,
fine
open my
tuning
box.
Of it,
yeah,
all and,
yeah,
and
not just be satisfied with jumping 482, like what's going to make me be the fourth woman to jump over five. And that's kind of was the ideal, to go there.
So fourth woman jumping over five, what would that mean to you, your family, this the country of Canada, the Olympic committee, yeah, people like me at Walter Magazine? I mean, it'd be amazing. I'd absolutely love it. But what would it mean for you?
It would be absolutely incredible. I mean, you know, it would be, you know, we always say, what is better, breaking a world record or bringing home hardware? Personally, I think bringing home hardware to show all my, what I've worked so hard for. But to jump 5 meter, that's just like the 6 meters for men, you know, and we always laugh when Bupka said, you know, women aren't really pole vaulters till they jump over 5 meters, and we always laugh at it because there's really only been three, so clearly there's something that's very meaningful for us women to jump over four. So I think, you know, there's about three girls right now that have that potential to do that. It's a lot of more mental for us, and a lot more, we know what fear is, and we see it and we feel it because we are natural women. We bring children into the world, and so I think that's the difference between the men and women's vault, is we interpret fear and hurting ourselves way easier than men do. And I think that's what stops us from gripping higher and gripping on bigger poles, but we're a lot prettier jumps.
Sure. Yeah. So you're at the Olympic Training Center. Coming up, you have a meet up in Walnut at Mount SAC this Sunday. Pretty stacked crew there too as well coming in. That'll be great competition. As you press forward and get ready for the Olympics and your training cycle and this, that, and the other, tell us a little bit about your coach back home in Canada.
Yeah, so Doug Wood and Zednik. Zednik's from Czech Republic, and coached Doug Wood when he was at the Olympics in 92. Doug Wood went 5.65, which I think is, I can't even, it's 18-something,
sure.
18 feet in there. And so it was really great because I had this coach, Doug Wood, who's been there, who's been at the elite level, who's competed against Bupka, competed against all those guys, and then I have Zeke, who coached him to be at that level. So I have the toughness of my Czech Republic coach, and then the soft heart Canadian coach that kind of gets my emotion side, that walks me through, okay, you're going to go to Europe, you have six meets, you're going to have two that are going to be awesome. You're going to have one, you're going to get off the runway and you're going to be like, why did I even come to this meet? And then the other ones are going to be mediocre. So he was my experienced coach, and they are just two peas in a pod, and without each other, they couldn't handle me. So I think your environment is very important, and who you're being coached by, because you have to have that communication. They need to know you inside and out, and that's what I have with Doug and Zeke back home. They just, they would walk me down an aisle. That's how much they know me. So
the last thing I want to kind of dive into for a second is your sponsors. I don't think that sponsors, you know, you wear their gear, you do this, you do that, and they gain their notoriety and their
awareness
mm-hmm. from you doing that. But what's it mean to be an elite athlete? And it may be just a silly question, I know, but to have something like Gill Athletics in your back pocket. I've done a lot of business with Gill Athletics, and they have sponsored this club, our pole putter uppers, our bleachers, our benches, all this kind of stuff. And I'm always talking about Gill and VS Athletics and bars, but you know, you're wearing Nike, you're jumping on Gill poles. Who else? What else? What's what does it mean to you, other than the obvious? It means the world and everything's great. And
no, I think it, you know, it takes a community to get the goals and dreams you want to accomplish. You know, it's nice to know that, you know, if I need a 0.2 stiffer pole, not a 0.6 in my series, that I can call Gill up and be like, hey, I need this to just make 4 centimeters more, you know, and that could be that metal. You know, to have people like that in your life, that it's just easier, you know. There's so many of those amazing stories. My spike broke 2 days before the World Championship, and Nike sent them to Doha for me. Like, it's nice to have that resources, because yes, maybe we're not making as much money as the elite level athletes, as NFL, NHL, you know, MLB. However, you know that we're out there because we actually love our event. We're not really out there because we're making all this money, even though that's a bonus. It's just so nice to build a community of people that like love and want to see you do well.
Well, your poles got smashed that time.
Yeah.
Completely destroyed. Mm-hmm. And within a couple weeks or 10 days or whatever, here's a whole new set of poles from Gill sent right out to you.
And Air Canada, everyone owned it. It was the most incredible thing. They invited me into the facility. I showed them where to put poles. Like, it was just amazing for me. It was so nice to see that people actually cared and wanted to see me do well. And it wasn't a negative anymore. It was actually like, that was a blessing in disguise, because now Air Canada has a special latch that they put for pole vaulters. And whenever they fly in and out of Canada, I get flights direct all the time because of wherever I'm going to compete at. So at the end of the day, I think everything happens for a reason, and what's meant to be is going to happen. But you definitely have to have this hope and this faith that people have your best interest. You do have to have that, but you always got to make sure, and you always got to know there's always competition out there. So to have that small group, I call it my 100% circle group, and those 4 or 5 people that I know, love, and do have my best interest, I keep them very, very close.
Yeah, what about Nike and the rest?
Nike's been amazing. I'm so thankful we just signed a 3-year contract, so Alysha will be around for at least 2 more Olympics.
Oh, no.
So I'm super stoked about that. They just saw the value in me as a vaulter and an upcoming vaulter. They've seen what I've been doing the last, I guess it's now 5 years since I turned pro out of university. So just getting better. I'm doing fun there. You know, I signed with Cadillac. Cadillac's an awesome company.
Oh, I've seen that. That's so cool.
They're incredible. I'm working with a couple of our local grocery, Queen Street Bakery.
You're not going to be in the Cadillac with old boy, are you? Who's the guy? Oh, he's a Lincoln. He's not Cadillac. What's his name? Matthew McConaughey, you're going to be driving down. Friggin'.
Oh, that'd be so fun.
Oh, yeah, it's leaking.
Yeah, no, I think there's some cool things coming out for Tokyo with Cadillac, with me and poles on the Cadillac.
Dude, that'd
so
be
you
cool.
guys got to
cool.
stay tuned for those ones, but that's going to be cool. So, yeah, it's really, and what I love about social and that part is I don't have to say yes to everything. You know, I say yes to what runs by my brand and what I believe in and what works with me. Like right now we're working with a lot of things for my house, because I just bought a house in 2020.
And I saw that.
And it's very exciting for me, because nobody told me how expensive just like a chair is, like $300. I'm sitting there like, what'd you, whoa.